And now, the Bonfire with Big J Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Yes! It is the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. We are with you. We are with you. I am your host, Big J Oakerson. Dan Soder hung up today in crazy scheduling today, sending people all over the place. We have no Dan. He had to call him in. Emergency scene, needed full penetration. He's the only person willing to do it. He's got a very, the doctors in the industry call it accepting anus. Bert Kreischer also held up by a travel itinerary. His plans got moved around, so he's not going to be able to be here today, but that doesn't matter, man. It's the Bonfire. It's hump day. We're through it. It's already after work, unless you're some L.A. shithead. It's time to party. And we, of course, always get to bring you awesome guest hosts joining us today. To my left, if you're watching, and you're not, America's Amigo, everybody, from the Amigos podcast on the Osiris Network. How about a hilarious Mike Finoy, everybody?
What's up?
And right across from me, everyone, you're so beloved, dude. They fucking love you. There's no, you're, Mike is America's Amigo. You're like America's big brother in some way. Yeah, I feel like that's what it is. I feel like people think you're a loyal guy that can call and you'll fight for them, everyone. Shane Gillis.
Wow.
Shane Gillis.
America is in good shape.
Wow. Me, Trump, all the true fucking ballers out here running this fucking country.
Kicking ass. I'm sneaking people through tunnels.
Fingering pussies, dude. What up? Me and Trump. Shout out Trump. What up, bull?
Dude, Shane. Shane yesterday came to goddamn Comedy Jam with me.
Oh, nice.
A lot of fun, by the way. Fun show.
Sal's birthday.
It was Sal's birthday. Sal feeling under the weather on his birthday, but a super happy birthday shout to Sal Volcano, our dear friend, one of Mike's employers, which is always nice, too.
Yeah, so
you gotta suck butt a little bit.
A little butt sucking.
A tiny bit.
Right.
Throw that butt suck. But last
refuse
night...
you lose, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
You suck butt?
A little bit.
Yeah, you gotta suck butt.
Watching comics... talk, you know, the obvious. Most of the comedy community's coming out. If you have a Trump joke, it's probably not pro-Trump.
Yeah.
And Shane just goes, while we're watching someone do jokes like that, Shane just goes, man, I'd love to go up there after this and just be like, yo, you guys are all gay. Trump rules.
I mean, it was a
would
crowd.
Original.
It was a crowd in Brooklyn when someone was on stage like, yo, I don't know about you guys, but I don't like this president. And everyone's like, yeah, fuck him. Dude, I would love to get up there and be like, yo, all your fucking dads who pay your fucking rent. Yeah. Love Donnie Trump, dude.
Yeah, I'd pretty much say anything to make a Brooklyn crowd pissed.
Yeah.
I fucking hate them.
Hell yeah.
I think last night was always potentially teetering on the edge. There was enough, they announced the lineup, and it's local enough that there was a lot of Skank fans there.
Mm-hmm.
Sal drew a large part of the audience, I'm sure. And then just the show has a fan base at this point. Nikki Glaser was on the show, but it was me and Lewis.
So also. a lot of Dancing with the Stars fans.
Yeah, a lot of Dancing with the Stars people coming through. No, but it just was a crowd that was balanced, and it felt like it was one person stirring it up, saying you guys are gay Trump rules, from it really going haywire.
That's awesome.
Would have been great.
I felt it was definitely. A tightrope walk.
What song do you sing after that? Fucking... Sweet Home Alabama.
Yeah, it's got to be so. God Bless the USA. Yeah,
Toby Keith Greenwood. Man.
Just don't tell me no lies and keep your hands to yourself.
Georgia Satellites.
Toby Keith would be sick after that.
Oh, like Iraq and Roll?
Yeah, dude.
That's a real song, right? He made Iraq and Roll.
Sounds
about, what do you think
correct.
Trump fucking
blowing
rocks
up,
to?
About like blowing up Arabs?
When he's walking slow motion on his treadmill. What do you think Trump's like fucking...
Trump definitely listens to like, what do you guys call it? Fucking like stepdad rock? No.
Yeah.
Yacht rock?
Yacht rock?
No, I don't think Trump...
I bet it's some weird like AC/DC or something.
Trump?
Yeah.
Yeah, something like that.
But what's like the poor man... Like the rich man's poor man's AC/DC? Like what's he listening to? Like
America?
You think so?
Listen to the band America.
Horse with no
I feel
name.
Like Trump's music tastes have to be corny as fuck. Like if he listened to AC/DC, I would genuinely like Donald Trump. Dude, if I found out he was blasting Back in Black, I'd be like, "Yo, this guy actually
he just
rules.
Plays big balls every morning in the shower."
Calls him Ang Young. I saw Ang Young one time. fabulous. Bring down the house at Red Rocks.
Really rocked. Fucking tore it up. Got head that night.
Son of a bitch tore it up.
I got head that night.
I want him to listen to like Marshall Tucker, like one off to the like Allman Brothers. One off to the left is Marshall Tucker.
Or it's gonna be as boring as you think, and just straight up like the standards, like Sinatra,
Tony Bennett.
He listens
to Tony Bennett's Christmas all year round,
no matter what. Or just some weird ethnic music from Melania's.
Yeah.
Like what? What's she for? She's what is she? Not Russian.
I don't know what the fuck she is. Hot.
Ukrainian. She was hot. I think we're giving it to her still too much.
What?
Still she's pretty goddamn hot, dude. She's got Madison Ivy face.
She's holding up. She's holding up well, but this is not a young model anymore.
She looks like a hot cat.
Yeah.
She looks like a real hot cat.
If there was a cat that I'd fuck, it would be her.
For sure.
She's from Slovenia?
Yeah.
Oh, Novo Mesto. She's from the NM.
How do they age? Look up old Slovenian women.
There are none, dude. They did not survive the Slavic fucking cleansing.
Yeah, they go from beautiful to wet catcher's mitt.
Yeah, that's what I'm picturing. It's going to go bad for them.
Fast.
She's going to be wearing a babushka in a year or two.
Trump would drop her in a second, dude.
What do we got? Is this old Slovenian women?
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, it's exactly how I pictured it would become. There's a woman who always has stew cooking in the kitchen.
Yeah, they just turned to wicker.
There's always a thick stew. And there's meat. There's no fat on that meat. That meat, lean as hell. It's been stewing for days.
They stir laundry with that giant fork like in Wonka.
That's what she's going to turn into. Just you can't stop that
she's
to
not,
some degree.
Dude, look at her. Oh, what are you talking about?
Yeah. That's not today.
She escaped that life, dude.
Yeah.
She escaped the babushka life.
But that's not today. Those naked pictures of her are not today.
Yeah, I don't care when those are.
Yeah, it looks great there, for sure.
This is what Trump listens to. And he's like, this AC/DC rocks.
I bet he listens to West Side Story and playlists like that.
There's nothing wrong with that. Is that Melania? Where's that from?
That's hot.
That can't be like her first lady shoot. You got to put that next to Barbara Bush, like the, you know, George H.W.'s wife.
Yeah, like,
just that old is like sitting there, like looks confused and lethargic.
This is in the same room with like Mrs. Eisenhower fox hunting.
Yeah. That bed is, if that's in the White House or is that a private jet, that whatever that's on has never had a shaved butthole on it before. That's the first time that's ever been a shaved and or waxed asshole.
Every time you guys bring pictures up, I just literally I stop talking and just stare at them.
Yeah,
it's fine.
That's a great picture.
I think she looks a lot like Madison Ivy.
But when's that from?
2000.
That's 2000.
Yeah, it's 20 years ago.
That's pre-9/11.
Yeah.
That was actually the plane that hit Tower 2. That's what she was on it.
Wow.
She was just sleeping on some fur. Thanks, Jacob.
Look, borderline flawless 20 years ago.
Yeah, Jesus.
I'm just saying it's funny. Like, she's if he wasn't president, he'd probably be on the way to putting her on the outski.
Yeah.
And just picking up another, like, 29 year old.
Yeah.
I think she'd be all right with that, too.
I think she's
served her sentence, dude.
Oh, yeah. She's earned the cashola she's got
to
get.
Yeah.
Waking up next to that fucking potato for all those years.
And you got
to
live in stupid D.C.
Yeah, my mom
woke
up.
Blocks, you go 2 blocks off the White House and just nothing but cornrows and gold teeth still.
Nothing wrong with waking up next to a potato, dude. Joan Gillis has been waking up next to a potato with a sleep apnea mask on for 40 years now. Yeah,
nice. Your dad's rocking the mask?
And poor as fuck. She's not making any money.
Well, does my your mom's dad... been putting in her time, too. Just not a potato, more a
does your dad...
calzone.
Does your dad tell you how great I had one person that sleeps with a CPAP hasn't come to sing me the praises of it?
No.
They haven't told you, he hasn't told you that it's fantastic?
I don't think he likes it, but he's usually fucked up. I think he's pretty much blacked out every time he puts it on, so I don't think he's experienced it once.
Or he's putting it on wrong. This part goes in your mouth. No, Dad, nothing goes in your mouth.
He puts it on his dick.
I've heard from everyone
who's tried it. On your mom?
Everyone who's tried it says it's a whole new experience.
Like it's good?
Like, fantastic. They said you don't even realize you haven't been sleeping for years. And they tell you that you, most people, you got to take the sleep test. See what they got to do to get you, find out if you have sleep apnea. They sleep test you, and they end up giving you back a number of how much you wake up in the middle of the night. And it's an insane amount of time. It's all technical wake-ups, not, like, things you remember. But some people, it's like, I just had people that probably don't have anywhere near my health level of
nice
bad.
As you. Oh.
No. Yeah, nowhere near on my level, you know, but I'm a statue, guys. No, far better health than me, I would assume. And they say, when they tested me, it turns out I wake up 116 times a night.
Holy shit.
And I died 4 times. Wow.
That's a night.
But to me, it's just like I was watching Bob's Burgers and I conked out and then I woke up to an alarm. Like, yeah. I didn't know so much happened in those hours. I've died several times.
I had a weird thing. 2 nights ago, I woke up laughing like 5 times. Throughout the night, I kept going to sleep and waking up laughing.
Really?
And that might... I was with, baby girl. Shout out, baby girl. She was in bed next to me. And I just kept throughout the night waking up laughing.
Do you remember... Were you dreaming?
I was dreaming, and I do remember the dream, because I told her right away. It was... I kept dreaming about my friend farting in class.
That's a fantastic
dream. Over and over again, I would laugh, wake up, and go back to sleep, back into my friend farting in a dream.
Were you going? Was the same fart still going, or did he go, where'd you go, Shane? Anyway, I broke it off for you. Here's the rest.
Classroom fart. Classroom. I'm 30 and nothing's still funny better. In my dreams,
dude. It's
dude.
The greatest.
In your dreams.
In my dreams.
What do you think that's about? That you miss like a simpler time when the world was just the funniest fart one? Like, won the day?
I don't know, because...
Now there's so much you have to go through.
I'm pretty much still on that level, dude. I really haven't matured too much.
Just waiting for a class. You spend your day waiting for a classroom
waiting
fart?
Waiting for a fart, dude.
That's great. I still have a nightmare that I'm late to, like, my last class.
Really?
Yeah. And I've had millions of jobs in between. Have you had that dream?
Yeah, I get that with football.
Yeah.
Like, I'm
late to practice.
Can't find my helmet or can't find it. Yeah.
I have a dream I'm late to an exam to graduate college. And I'm 39 years old.
I've
had a million jobs in between. I don't give a fuck about being late to those jobs.
Yeah.
But it's just college for some reason.
I have no dreams of school. I have, every couple years, I wake up remembering that I had a dream about meeting up with my ex-girlfriend from like high school or right after high school. And that it's some magical whirlwind, like, we were supposed to be together, and this weird thing, everyone's got to figure their life out.
Yeah.
And then I wake up, not going like, oh, maybe I got to look her up. I'm right away like, what? That was nowhere near going to work out.
Wow.
I don't think about her in daily life at all.
Now, see, if you were wearing your sleep apnea mask, she never would have been there.
Yeah, or I would have stayed in that dream long enough to inception kill her or something.
Also, I never fuck in dreams.
No.
For a while, I was always just about to fuck, and then you wake up.
But I've had a long route to getting to fucking.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which is actually sometimes great.
Yeah.
And then you cum your pants in your bed.
Yeah. And then you wake up laughing.
Yeah.
I've never in my life, we've had this discussion on the air before, but I've never had a wet dream in my life. I don't even know what that is.
Yeah,
it doesn't make any sense.
You texted me and asked me about it. I definitely did.
You did?
Woke up with load in my pants for sure.
Not like a full load, but
some wet, some nocturnal emission.
Pre-cum, I would not call that a wet dream. Is that what we're calling a wet dream? Then yeah, sure. Nightly.
I don't know. Do people have full fucking loads?
I mean, I'm not. It's so great.
I thought about taking off with like a fucking spider web on your chest.
Your mom walks by your room and is like, hug it. Egg it.
Shane looked over nervous at Christine when I said about my dream. Was that something that would make you... You have to have dreams about guys from your past.
I feel like I don't remember my dreams. It's
ever?
Very rare.
I feel like Christine.
Yeah, it's rare for me too. It's very rare for me to remember dreams. Just the important ones about my ex-girlfriends.
Did you have a recurring one when you were a kid? Did you ever have like a recurring one when you were a kid?
Nah. Not really.
I had a fucking weird one. I was in like a warehouse and there were all these boxes and there's one of those cars where like, you know the railroad cars that like you kind of do
pump?
This?
Yeah.
And there was a dude with like... almost like Dick Tracy looking, like detective hat, and like, but it was a shadow. And they went by the boxes, and then the car kept going, and he wasn't there. And I would like wake up in a fucking like sheer terror.
Oh God!
Yeah,
man.
And I'd have to turn all my lights on, and yeah.
I wish I was a scarier thing happening in that dream. To
I know that was it.
And I'd wake up in sheer terror from that shadow.
Turns
that
out my grandfather
away.
Was just fist in my face.
Yeah, I'd wake up and I have tried to do the go back asleep, get back into the dream, but
oh yeah,
never
happened. That's what every fucking dream ends with. You wake up, you
try
like,
to get back.
God
into
damn it, I gotta get back in there.
Yeah, now you're just in a field.
And then you guys ever have sleep paralysis?
Yes. Holy shit. Remember I told you in the apartment I did. You had it in when we were in...
Is that what that's called? Sleep paralysis?
When you can't move, right?
You can't move, yeah.
It's like halfway between... Like you're almost awake.
It's insane.
But are you really awake?
right, this is my harrowing experience. All right, this is going to get very spooky in here.
Yeah.
All right. Should we lower the lights more?
Some music.
It's I had just broken up with my girlfriend. Like my first like major.
You do
us in
a Vincent Price voice. The midnight hour was close at hand.
I was handling it like a real pussy. I didn't eat for 3 days. I was like real sad about this girl.
Wow.
And then I took fucking Z-Quil to go to sleep. And I, in the middle of the night, I woke up naked in my parents' basement. That's how I slept. Fuck yeah.
No matter what.
Yeah, dude. That's,
yeah. That wasn't just because of all the concoction you took.
No, that's just
that's
how you
become, get down.
That's how you become great.
Yeah.
But in the middle of the night, I wake up and there's a fucking just shadowy figure standing at the foot of my bed. And like, I'm awake. You're awake at this point. And it started walking towards me with its fucking hand out towards my face. And it was the realest thing possible. And then I woke up and tried to fight it. That's it.
Mine was
that's it.
That I guess it is sort of like.
So I started fighting in the dark, naked, in my parents' basement.
It is sort
pretty
of
sick.
It that's is sort awesome. Of the thing. I had I was up just. What did I sleep like 4 hours or something in like 3 days? And it was just, I was just traveling from gig to gig. And the last one I did with Mike, we were in a casino in
Oklahoma,
fucking Nowhereville, Oklahoma.
Twin Peaks style hotel. Like,
yeah, totally. It's like a wood cabin casino.
Yeah, the bed frame's like carved out of like old totem poles.
Yeah.
Like it's real fucking weird. Yeah.
Yeah, the bed frame is like logs fit into holes in other logs. And it was, I was just out of it. And I remember going in my room and trying to go to sleep, just watching my laptop. And I guess I fell asleep, but I knew for sure. It's almost, I guess the explanation is like your dream is what's happening right in that moment.
Mm-hmm.
Because the dream was I was just laying there watching TV in that bed, and I knew for some reason that Mike had gotten into my room, and he was just, this isn't even like so much to be scary, it was just that Mike was in the room, and I knew it was him, and he was going to try to like scare me, and I knew that, and I'm telling you my eyes were open, and I'm trying to say, Mike, I know you're there, but like my mouth wouldn't open. It was crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it was
wild,
like scary.
Man.
I was like, and then I sat up and like just kind of like came to and realized that Mike in fact was not there. I did check, but he was not there, and I crashed. But it was like 30 seconds of the most terrifying. Like just no idea. What's
I didn't
happening.
Know. I didn't know what sleep paralysis was. And I was just like, dude, I just got visited by a fucking ghost.
You got
for sure. And I was like, I can't tell anyone about this, dude. This is fucking crazy.
I have terrifying thoughts. I haven't had a surgery or been under anesthesia since I got my tonsils out when I was a kid. And the idea of having to get a surgery now, where most people are like, yeah, it's a minor surgery. It's like 3 hours, I'll be out. And the idea of going under completely anesthesia. I went to the dentist not long ago and they gave me the gas for something, was it wisdom teeth? That was pretty cool.
It's fucking great.
That was pretty awesome. But it didn't knock you out or anything. But now getting put out, even because there's that one billionth chance that like you just react and don't come out of that.
You just stay there.
Or the biggest fear, there was one movie about it. The kid who played Anakin Skywalker.
Hayden Christensen
was in a movie where he goes under anesthesia. And he's completely aware of what's happening to him.
That's like an old Tales from the Crypt, too.
You just know. You can't do it.
They started
doing completely,
like, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Like the guy's nervous system. The guy's nervous system was still fully intact, but he was dead. And they started to, like, he was like a donor. And they started just cutting into him. And you could hear him screaming, but on the inside. It's fucking,
That's more far-fetched. This one was just a surgery where the guy completely aware was happening.
Yeah.
It's really that scares the shit out of me.
Yeah.
Any idea of that? Jacob, you came said over. Did you have sleep paralysis in your life?
Or were you just getting scared?
Were you getting scared back there by yourself?
You're scared in the corner.
I don't want to be in the corner.
The haunted corner. What'd you say, Lou? What?
My mic's not working there, so I moved over.
Jacob Beckley, you've been on radio before.
but I had to. I thought you meant paralysis. I couldn't move. I took that.
Well, you can't move. Well, dude, you just took an oxygen.
I'm new at taking it.
That's not paralysis. That's called killing it.
Yeah, dude, that's called fucking party time. Dude.
I was terrified because I woke up 2 hours, like I fell asleep to it and I couldn't move. And I finally woke up and I was trying to move my body. And I took a heavy dose of this pill.
You know what your body was saying? You weren't done yet.
All right, body. I'll take the hint. Hello.
Bring me back.
Is there anybody in there?
Like Shane.
I'm ready to fly.
I don't know if it's Shane. I never had a sex dream.
Shane, you have any friends you could bring? You want to get some girls?
I like to stare at girls on the subway.
I always wake up right before.
There's nothing wrong with it.
You wake up before fucking in a dream.
Yeah,
of course.
Nuts, like I'll
do you ever have squirt all over your shorts, though?
Never happened.
Yeah, wet dream?
Not even just a little bit.
As long as like I drop, it's some...
Like a drip of...
Mundane thing. No, in the dream, like I drop a pair of keys. It's the one thing preventing me to get to...
I feel like
to fucking somebody.
I feel like that's kind of how you don't fuck in real life. Like in real life, you're about to be with a chick and you're like, oh, I fumbled my keys.
You're just dropping the proverbial keys.
I get a lot of puss.
Christine, do you ever wake up wet and then think, I must, if you don't remember your dreams, you go, I guess I had like a sex dream or something?
Yeah, it's happened in my life. I was just reading up an article on it, but it's really funny because it says, can women have wet dreams too?
It'd be great if Christine is middle of the night just like flips over and squirt.
She's like a fucking, just a sleep geyser.
And it's just so funny how much women don't come during sex.
She's like, oh, equal pay.
It's about how women don't come during
sex. It says, well, sex dreams always end in orgasm. It says, nope, think about it this way. Do you have an orgasm every time you have sex? Probably not. That's such a female.
What a punch in the balls.
Christine's a sleep Bellagio. And just fucking... the little fountains.
She's the Rio.
She's the Rio.
When
sex dreams, but sleep orgasm? Probably not. Probably not.
Nothing that I've never like woken up from it.
But you ever wake up and like, I gotta fucking rub one out? Like from the dream?
It must be.
But
I
you
would
don't
assume
know.
Whatever I was, yeah.
But you never actually woke up and was like, oh, that thing that was happening in the dream was, it's just like, I guess I...
Or not that I can remember off the top of my
head. Is that when you were
Yeah, that's weird. It's almost
drinking?
Weird to wake up and go, it's like, I don't know why, but I'm fucking nailing this thing right now. I'm going to fucking Hammer Town right now.
Is that when you were drinking more?
No, sometimes, I mean, honestly, sometimes it's like, if you know, it could be the night before.
Sure, whatever,
but nothing that I'm like, remember waking up and I was having a sex dream and I was like, oh, I gotta finish this in real life.
Black Lou, you fucking your dreams?
I have a few times.
Yeah?
Is it gangster shit?
Completion?
No, honestly, it's just me and like a Taylor Swift lookalike.
Poof.
Or an ex.
I actually dream about the same thing, dude. You.
Blue fucking Taylor Swift.
Black dude and Taylor Swift.
I mean, who hasn't?
I dream about him watching you fuck a Taylor Swift lookalike.
We can do this, guys.
DJ Lou. Tons of wet dreams.
No.
I bet your sweatpants look like leopard prints.
No, I came close actually last night, but I couldn't. Something happened to her.
What happened?
She evaporated. I don't know what the fuck happened to her.
You're ghost fucking.
Yeah.
Wait, this happened to you last night?
Yeah, last night.
Wait, what happened?
How weird.
She was hot, she was blonde, and I was about to do the deed, and then something happens.
Oh, it's a dream?
Yeah, yeah.
That doesn't happen in life. No, I don't have those dreams, but I'm out there crushing real ass.
Real evaporating women.
Evaporating ass. Then she went away. And she goes, don't worry, Lou, I came. And he goes, ditto.
Dude, you told that time. When you couldn't scream in your, you know, like you couldn't talk to me in when you were sleeping. When my wife and I first moved into our new place, I had a dream recurring that I kept hearing something in the kitchen, and I would walk down the hall, and then when I got to the kitchen, I'd look out the window, and looking into the house was like, you remember that kind of like, what was he, that Mexican guy from Ghost?
He was a comic.
Yeah.
Rick Aviles?
Yeah, him. Maybe not him, but a lookalike is looking into my place, and right when I make eye contact, he disappears, and I try to scream like at him, and I guess in my sleep, I was going like, like whimpering, and it would wake my wife up. She'd be laughing at me like, you fucking pussy, like, what are you, you're whimpering, and you're, but I'm in my dream, I'm like pointing and screaming, but in real life, it's coming out like,
to a little Mexican guy.
Well, it's a scary face in the window at night.
Like a little Hispanic.
Yeah.
I'm not a little guy.
Do you think, Mike, there's any chance that you dreamed the coming of Poncho Mike?
Possibly.
Is that what you saw in that dream?
That was the window to my future.
Hey, what you dreaming about, buddy? Eh?
That's just my sleeping experiences.
Hey, maybe you'll get a sleep app machine, right? You can sleep a little bit longer. This fucker dies 15 times in his dreams, right? But that's just Poncho Mike's experiences.
That was him out there.
And then I saw an evil Hispanic face. As I got closer,
it was just me with a very racist Mexican mustache. Poncho Mike lives.
Spirit Day!
Hey, everybody in there get some pussy in their dreams, right? That's crazy. Every time I'm about to put my chacleta into a punani, I wake up. But that's just Poncho Mike experience.
What? Look at Sarah.
Who?
Where?
Sarah McPants.
Of course.
Says, I've had orgasms and dreams many times. But how do you know? How do you know, Sarah? You have orgasms. How do you know that?
I think just she sticky means she's pants? Actually has an orgasm. Like, she's dreaming about having an orgasm. Maybe she's orgasmed.
Oh, and felt like the feeling. Oh, in the dream? I don't know if I can consider that an orgasm in real life. Just pop off in your dream? And then what? Then I fall asleep in my dream. Then what happens?
Then I have a dream cigarette.
Does a wormhole open?
Imagine if it's just boring after. I have a dream cigarette. And I have some juice.
I watched the first three episodes of Wild Wild Country. The slowest episode.
I ate some dream peanut butter. Yeah, it sounds fucking... Sick. And I wonder why, like, I mean, that's just crazy that we've all pretty much have gotten right to there, but never actually fucking a dream.
I don't think I have.
Know what I mean?
Yeah.
I've even like...
When you see a point of view anyway, when you just see like the face or something, I don't think...
It's almost
I don't think if I see myself
allure.
In third or first person in dreams. Can't think.
You probably see it first person.
You think
in
that,
a dream.
Right?
Yeah, like, you don't see eyes. Third person in a dream, I don't think.
See myself?
It's like, pretty cool if
it's
you
like
do.
It's like theatrical. It's like Red Dead style.
Yeah, you're just playing Grand Theft Auto all day? That's awesome.
That's a great dream. Dude, how was not eating for 3 days and then taking
Z-Cool?
I was
so fucking gay about this breakup.
Yeah, Matt's
really
gay.
It's actually really embarrassing. I shouldn't have shared that.
No, keep going.
But
was it your last relationship?
I went off the deep end.
Was
after.
It was before this?
It was the one before the last.
Yeah,
No. It wasn't the most recent breakup. It was the one before that.
How old were you?
23.
First girl 22. That you were like madly
that was the first
in love
like
with.
Long. Yeah, yeah, that was like a 3-year relationship.
Yeah, I went off the deep end after my worst breakup. I moved to Colorado.
I was
cocaine.
Hell yeah. No, that's so much cooler than what I did, dude. I cried in my parents' basement.
Now we've all done that age. That's an age to do weird stuff.
Yeah.
I knew the area where the guy my ex-girlfriend dumped me for, like, lived, and when I would come back from New York at night on my way home, I would just, like, see if I saw her car in the area door. Not really prepared to do anything. I don't know what I would possibly do.
No,
just go outside and yell at the thing.
Hey,
sorry to bother you at your boyfriend's house, but can I get some of my CDs back?
I left that helmet CD in your car.
I didn't have, like, my personality just wasn't, like... fight this guy. I knew it had nothing to do with him.
Dude, I worked with a guy who turned, like, I was doing sales and we had cubicles next to each other, and he lifted his head over the cubicle and he goes, listen, I know we haven't been tight, but I'm going to take you under my wing. I just went through this. We're going to get through this together. And it was his idea of getting me through this was just coke and strippers, and literally,
it's
like
crazy.
That was it. Was
dude,
literally like leaving work, going to the gym, then going to drink, then going to the Scruples in Bridgeport.
Scruples.
people that did, like, I just went through a pretty major breakup, and a lot of people's advice was like, dude, just fucking go get some strippers. It's like, what are you, like, a fucking psycho?
It's crazy. It's really crazy. Yeah.
What's the best, if anybody wants to call in, and I'll call this a caller topic if you want to have fun with that, Lou. I'll bring it up again before we actually have it happen. So we're going to take our first break. But I'd like to hear callers call in with best names for their local strip clubs. I mean, only if it's a good one. It's got to be. I don't have one personally. Ours was Fantasy Show Bar, which is lame. For sure, but like it wasn't that. Also, Scruples makes me laugh.
There's one north of Harrisburg called Fantasy Island.
Yeah,
it's just this like shit. No, but north of Harrisburg's like along the Susquehanna River. It's like a real shithole. Like,
that's what
on
makes
a
it
swamp.
The island.
Yeah, it's like a real.
Oh, like what's crusty about it? All right, so the name's not good. What's crusty about your local strip club?
Yeah.
If you want to call in the number 844-COMEDY-9. Black Lou's ready to take your calls. We're going to take our first break. We're hanging out. Shane Gillis, Mike Fenoya. It's the Bonfire. You know, we're talking about all this dreaming here. I think we could all agree that in most bedrooms, bedtime can be complicated, especially as the weather begins to cool. One person sleeps sound and the other one is either freezing or way too hot. Do you find that with your wife, Mike, that you guys are...
Yeah.
Are your cold sleeper. Am I right? You like to sleep with a cold?
I like it as cold as possible with a lot of blankets.
Yes, me too. Shane, what are you? Naked in your parents' basement?
Naked, cold in my parents' basement. Naked and afraid.
A lot of ghosts.
Lots of ghosts. Fighting ghosts, dude. Crying. Classic.
Well, let me tell you something. Bowl and Branch, the makers of the world's most comfortable sheets, loved by three U.S. presidents, are now offering their luxury flannel bedding for a limited time at bowlandbranch.com. Me and Christine have been using them now for a couple weeks. We took them today to get washed, so we're going to see how they hold up with that. But the other sheets we got there just get softer and softer. They're warm, breathable, everyone stays the right temperature, and the flannel sheets now come in 14 patterns and colors, so you're guaranteed to find a style you'll love. Plus, you can try them for 30 nights risk-free. So how do you argue with that? 30 nights you get to try, you don't like it, send it back. But whatever you do, don't wait, because last year the flannel sheets sold out in just a few weeks. So go to bowlandbranch.com today for $50 off your first set of sheets, plus free shipping with promo code BONFIRE. That's $50 off, plus free shipping right now at bowlandbranch.com, promo code BONFIRE. That's Bowl and Branch, spelled B-O-L-L and branch.com, promo code BONFIRE.
And now back to the Bonfire with Big J Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Sexy stripper songs, if you're wondering what the theme is. Right here on the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. The phone, do I have to reload the phone bank here, or is not one person called about their local strip club? Tons of calls?
Yep.
I'm looking at a bunch.
I got to bump it down. I know how to do it, Jacob. Don't you? Don't you? I'm learning. I'm learning technical stuff. And just like that, your job is defunct. Just like that. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Big J Oakerson. Dan Soderoff doing his billions of things. The amigo himself, Mike Fenoya. His next Amigos Live at the Comedy Cellar is going to be on November 21st. Make sure you get tickets for that at thecomedycellar.com. It's comedycellar.com. And make sure you download his Amigos podcast, available on iTunes on the Osiris Network. Shane Gillis, of course, a fair one on Compound Media. Dan Soder going to be at Rumors Winnipeg, Canada. That is November 15th through the 17th, and after that, he's going to be at Laugh Boston. And Boston's big. They love us in Boston, man. Please come out and support Dan. November 29th through September 1st. Get tickets at dansoder.com. Best of the Bonfire, our podcast, comes out wherever you download your podcasts from. Subscribe, please listen, rate, review, give us 5-star reviews, let us know you're listening, and watch our videos on Comedy Central's YouTube channel. Our videos, they break down the best of the week, and it's just half-hour clips. It's a different experience being in the room with us. You should watch it. Take it in that way. It's very fun. We're hopefully trying to do some bigger things with the video element of the show, so please check that out. And then this weekend, Hasbrook Heights, New Jersey, Bananas, me, and the amigo himself are going to be there Friday and Saturday. One show Friday, two shows Saturday. Make sure you get tickets for that. Come out, say hi. Please, I'm working the crowd. I have no material, so please, God, be there. And then, of course, the homecoming, Philadelphia, Helium. I will be coming home to you November 15th through the 17th also.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. I can't wait.
There, start it from scratch, Lou. It's fine. Now, he's going to play the Depeche Mode one now? Fuck it. Slide it in. I got 12 more plugs I can do. No, Philadelphia, November 15th through the 17th. Get tickets for all my shows, bigjcomedy.com. We got a bunch. We do have a lot of calls. You're right, Lou. It did light up. I'm going to go so I know how to I do this here. We got Nick. Nick in Detroit. Nick, you there, buddy?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hey, you're on the air. Crackle, crackle.
Hey, so south of Detroit, this little shithole named Downriver, the big street called Dick Road, and they have a strip club on there called Chicks on Dicks. It was actually on an episode of Bar Rescue.
Dick?
They tried to bar rescue it?
John Taffer walked in.
First thing you want to do is get the herpes off these stools.
Oh, it won't. Without acid, it ain't coming out.
Yeah, was it just like a grimy place when you went in there?
It was. It's very tacky. You could smell the STDs in the air coming off the girls.
How much was it for a lap dance?
It's pretty special down there. They're $1 a lap dance.
Come on.
Dollar.
Then that's a song. That's a whole song? $1? It's jukebox fucking prices.
A dollar's a table tip. Let me tell you something. There's two women in the studio who have never stripped in their lives, I don't think. And both of them seem like a dollar is not... You have to be pretty down your luck to go for a dollar and do a full blow.
A lot of them didn't look like they had a lot of life choices.
What do you tip nickels? What do you fucking just throw hard points
What are you normally giving them for not the lap dance?
We're making a hail on them.
She's like, sir, can you just get a lap dance and stop making me break these dollars?
Just drink tickets.
Yeah, Chuck E. Cheese. They take Chuck E. Cheese tickets. That is pretty gross. Nick, thanks for the call, buddy.
Yep.
Well, this sounds like a good... there was one when me and Kurt first became friends. His chick was dancing at a place, not nude. It was go-go bar, like bikini, but it was called Billy's Beef and Go-Go.
Really?
In Gloucester. Look, you can see that up. It was in Gloucester, New Jersey. Billy's Beef and Go-Go. I went in a few times. It looked like, it was like brightly lit.
Oh.
It was like cafeteria lights and just girls like.
Really?
Oh, just, you saw everything.
Dude,
sores, shave burn.
Oh,
oh no.
Dude, like when they say like lunch with a view, there's a place in Hartford called Cahoots and it's lunch with a view and it's like, lunch? Like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, who's fucking coming here for lunch, for Christ's sake?
I crushed lunch for a while at strip club.
Did you see it? How's lunch strip club?
Yeah, it was a nice place. We talked about it before. It was a place called Savannah's in Harrisburg, dude.
Yeah.
Good wings.
Really?
Yeah.
That's not bad.
It's good wings. I don't know what
else to say. Weirdest thing I've ever done was I went to a... And I would tell you the grimiest stuff if I did it, but like... I went to a swingers thing at a strip club one night, like in the strip club basement, which was just ridiculous. It was It was like a swingers club.
Yeah,
you went to a swingers club?
Yeah. Yeah, with my ex. But we went and like looked around. It was so bizarre. It was the only
Of course it was.
But yeah, we watched a black couple fuck on a couch while a weird chubby guy, just like a creepy, came by himself, which I didn't know you were allowed to do that. Was in a catcher's position, just beating his dick.
And
the black guy kept looking back and being like, yo, man, get out of here. Gotta get out of here now. And then go back to fucking that emotional shift.
Wow.
From like, yeah, you want, come on now. You're getting a little close, dog. But while all that was happening, me and my ex enjoyed a nice baked ziti.
There you go.
Caesar salad.
Yeah. You ate at that?
Yeah, it was tins. They had, little, like, with the...
Like church,
what do you
like
call that? Chafing dish.
Yeah. Yeah. Like
chafing
sterno.
Sternos. Yeah.
Oof, that's way worse than
and
strip
a nice
club wings.
Yeah. Wisecrackers in Allentown.
Well, it wasn't near the action. The ziti wasn't near the action, if that's what you were wondering. We brought our plate of ziti to the action. What was that, Mikey?
Wisecrackers in Allentown, Pennsylvania. One time I was there working with Chips Cooney. And
lucky.
I know. Bragging. Precious Evening Swingers Convention was going on there. And it was all the same couples. It was all enormous black dudes and fat white chicks. And they were all, they had the third floor. So I was doing shows downstairs. And then I walked up there and they just had a plate of keys. And they would like, they were mingling, drinking.
Key party,
fucking
drinks. That's like a thing. That's like a 70s thing, and isn't it? The key party. Everyone puts their keys in a fishbowl and then you just go home
like
with whoever you keep. But that's fucked up.
Wow.
They would grab a room key and just like meet up with couples and just, you know, like go over.
How many people definitely fucked not a person they want to fuck doing it that throw a dart?
Well, I asked the couple.
Whose key is this? Mine. You're like, I guess I have to fuck that guy by the rules.
I think what this was it was like these were the rooms that were open to go fuck in. You know what I mean? So like if you met a couple you wanted to fuck, you'd be like, oh, let's go grab a key from whatever. And it had like, this is room 213.
I hope they're all different things. Like you have to go to the stranger into a spaceship room. Fucking glow in the dark butt plugs everywhere, like probes.
I asked a couple about it. I was like, so what if she wants to fuck a dude and you're not into the chick? And he was like, sometimes you just, you know, you got to be a team player. And I'm like, no, you don't. Like, that's just not,
you don't have to do this. You don't have to live
but
like
how
this.
Not into the chick do you have to be to not be
saying,
in there?
Yeah. But the guy was like, I'm not letting just anybody, like, have sex with my wife. Like, she's got to be, like, I have to know him. I have to talk to him. I have to, like, you know. I'm like, so you're, like, 30-second vetting process before you fucking.
Yeah, it should always be someone, like, you're finding some semblance of, you know what I mean? Like, even if you're like, not face, but body's great or whatever, you know.
Yeah, you gotta do something.
You gotta meet a guy.
If you're like, I can't stand this at all. Like, you're like, you should never just do that. Like, I feel bad.
It's crazy.
I feel like at the vetting process, you could be like, could I raise this guy's kid?
Right.
You know, because that's a fucking nightmare, dude. Fuck, I don't, do you do that stuff?
What?
Swing?
No, but we went to, I said, I just went to that thing once. It was like a strip club by our house called Goldfingers, and they would just say that it was a...
No, I would eat there.
When we would drive through, when we would drive, because it was like on the main street there. It was like right on like a main street in Queens Boulevard, and it said things like swing parties, like Saturday night, and it was just like, we get home so late, and we just went over there, like, let's go see what it is. And we went down there, because you don't have to do anything. You can just go, you know what I mean? But I didn't know there was, like, single guy. It's so weird. Just the guy, like, that guy's
catcher's
down.
Position?
That's catcher's fucking position.
Sick. One leg out, Tony Pena style.
I might try that tonight.
You're in Queen, dude.
Catcher's position, jerk off.
Goddamn.
I mean.
Oh.
You thought going to the swingers club?
On my bed.
It's a weird thing. I think it's a single guy. I'm
ready for a suicide squeeze.
I think a single guy in a swingers club, you have to. I think you have to pay more. Do you know what I mean?
But I think it's like, anything to the party.
I think it's like, if I remember, it was like, just to use an example, it's like 40 for a couple and like 150 for a guy.
You should at least bring like Gatorade and like a spray bottle and like cool off the couples.
Just have some, you have like a squeegee, a jizz squeegee. You know, for everyone's camera covers.
Hey, get a good pit crew.
We have so many calls. Let's take another. Well, here you go. You guys want to hear about one in Queens?
Yeah.
Grimy strip club in Queens. We have Zach. Zach, what's up, buddy? You're on the Bonfire.
Hey, what's going on, man?
What's up, dude? What's the grimy strip club in Queens? Did I nail it with Goldfingers?
Well, I've been to Goldfingers. That's a complete shithole. The worst was Wiley's back in the day. They used to let us in when we were 15. You didn't have a liquor license. You had a pound on a metal door. Some big black guy named Wendell would frisk you down.
Wendell.
I love everyone knows him.
Oh, yeah. Then you go in there into this pit, and they ask the waitress what kind of beer they have. She's like, we got Bud, Bud, and Bud. And that was it. They just had Bud.
What do the girls look like? A lot of bush in this place?
A lot of bush, a lot of illegals, a lot of girls with illegals. Bullet holes in their ass.
Get him out of here.
Bullet holes in the ass. Know, you gotta pay extra for those fancy clubs to pull that off.
Yeah, wow.
You got a girl with bullet holes in her ass back there?
Two assholes?
You have to bang on a bus. Now, by the way, sounds like a fantastic place. Ideally, I hear about this when I'm 15. I'm so intrigued to go, and I wanted to see naked women so bad when I was 15. But when we got to the alley with the big metal door you had to pound on, I don't know. By the time Wendell opened a little slide in the door and went, yeah, I went, we should go, man. We should go. My grandmother's going to freak out if I go home.
Yeah, I was going to say, Mr. Wendell, that's a dark ending to that Arrested Development song.
Could you get laid in there,
man,
Zach?
Take two.
You wear jogging pants with no underwear.
Everyone says that. Everyone says that about getting the grind dance on your dick through the... windbreaker pants, but I've never done that. One, I don't feel like I could wear that. I feel like my ass crack would sweat too much in windbreaker pants with no underwear on, and it would just be like, it would just be humid in those pants.
I think that's,
humid would be the word I would describe in those pants. Like wearing one of those,
she would just dance.
When you wear like the garbage bag outfits and run,
she would dance your pants right off of you because your ass would sweat.
Yeah. Or you just grip and rip the material because your ass is too sweaty against the grind.
Just wake up with some chafe.
I don't know. To do any of this, I feel like you got to be a fucking weird dude.
Yeah.
To do what?
I've never, I just don't have this,
to go what?
This side in me. Mm. Do the fucking pants like that? You're trying to fucking nut. You're trying to like sneak a cum.
I'm not judging. People that are in strip clubs like that,
they do that
whole
shit all the time.
To it. Yeah.
I have friends that do it. They wear like gym shorts in.
You know, the only reason
you're trying to sneak cum. That's fucking crazy.
Yeah,
The reason I can't get into it very much at a strip. I can go with, like, if it was so convenient that there's no effort to go there, and I was going with people, if like the three of us were going to go, or, you know, this group here was going to go, it's like, we'll laugh and have
fun. Yeah, break balls.
It'll be a fucking, like, goofy thing and experience. The idea of just going, like, dude, you want to hit the strip club? And look, I'm like, man, not even sort of, man.
Yeah, like, it's like, it goes back to, like, somebody being like, I'm trying to get over this breakup. It's like, you want to go see some, like...
economically downtrodden women try to fucking make you come through your sweatpants. Yeah,
that you can't touch.
I like going to Show and Tell in Philly because that was BYOB. I just fucking, me and my friends would just bring
post
like
up
two cases of Natty Light and just black out. It was great. Yeah, that's how I enjoy it.
Yeah, but there's no, you're not really like, again, Zach, was this place a place you can get laid? Could you pay to fuck there?
No, there was no rooms. The guys did get jerked off out in the open. There was definitely cum on the floor.
Wow. Definitely cum on the floor.
Where in Queens is this place?
Everywhere.
This was back in the day. It was by Roosevelt Avenue. If you know anything about Roosevelt
sure.
Avenue, yeah.
Yeah, it's where it gets a little silly. Now I think it's very trans-heavy, trans-hooker-heavy on Roosevelt Avenue.
Yeah, back in the day, it was the home of the $21 whorehouse.
Oh, that's cheap.
At least it's got a hook.
$21
$21
It's what only, was in there? Asian?
No, they're all South American. You had a 15-minute time limit. Yeah, this is like the early 90s.
Man, wow. Where's that kind of capitalism today? Thanks for the call, Zach. That does sound grimy.
We had a place that was Cleopatra's and Club International. Cleopatra's was naked. Alcohol free.
Yeah.
And then Club International was
topless
and booze. But we would go in with like the fakest of fake IDs. And then we would just bring a backpack full of beers.
In the no alcohol.
And we were like
one.
15. Yeah. And we were like sophomores in high school. Like,
oh, that's
brown,
pretty crazy.
Brown bagging like a Bud Kinger or like a court, you know.
Well, you
like,
could have went at 18. That's what's cool. But that's the one I went to. We went when we were 18.
Yeah.
Because there was no alcohol.
I got over strip clubs super fucking quick.
Me too. I was over strip clubs before I could drink legally anyway, yep. Which I never really did. But to this day still, if it was you want to go to a strip club and it was like you want to see the girls really split and gash and no alcohol or alcohol and boobs, I'm going naked. I'm going full nude every time. I just don't care about booze enough to make them like, no, if we're going to go see naked, let's go see naked women. If you want to go like see normal women and flirt and bullshit and talk, then go to a place. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like a regular bar. I don't get the point. Like, is if the point's not seeing them completely naked, then what's the point? Just watching a girl dance with her tits shaking around and seeing something like, eh.
I went to Fantasy Island with my friend, and when we got there, we were the only ones in there. It was just four strippers sitting smoking cigarettes under a smoke alarm that kept going off. It kept going off, and they would stand up and shake it away and sit back down and smoke. It was like, dude, sit at any other table. But then me and my friend sit up front, and they were like, fine, and go up and dance. And a couple of them were okay, but then a big dog got up, chubby lady, and she tried to do a spin on the pole, and when she hit the ground, she like slid. And you know that sound you make like at basketball when you slide on the hardwood?
Sure.
She came to a screeching halt like right in front of us. And we started dying laughing, and all the other strippers came out. We're like, you fucking assholes, don't fucking laugh. And we got kicked out. It's pretty great.
For laughing at her almost laughing. Falling?
Yeah, we were literally the only people in the room, and she tried to do a spin and slid, screeched on the fucking ground. Like, it definitely burnt her arms.
No guy has a better experience from at a strip club than a girl will have. Christine's been the one strip club with me. I paid for everything. They drove us there, the club, and Christine pulled a stripper. Like, everything that would never happen to me in a fucking strip club ever was as a girl's experience.
Nice. Go,
they just give them so much more like leeway. Just chatted a girl up. She wanted to leave, and I was like, get a lap dance. And she was like, nah, I don't care. And then it was kind of funny, too, because it's like, that's like Philly in the middle of fucking bumfuck, like, Airportville, where this club was. But it was a fan of the show sent, like, a car for us. And I was like, it was just so, like, again, there was no reason to say no, and she'd never been. So I was like, wow, they sent, like, a fucking, basically a limo for us and set us up with, like, booze. Christine was still drinking at the time, set me up with booze. He gave us a bunch of booze and food all in the house. And it was like, just tip the girls. And we just kind of hung and watched the shows for a bit. And then I was like, you have to get a lap dance. She was like, nah, I don't want to get a lap dance. And I was like, I'm like, you came to a strip club. You can't. Because we were getting ready to leave. We only stayed for like 45 minutes, an hour. So it was very short. And then we're getting ready to leave. And I was like, no, you're not going to get one lap dance. Like, there's not one person. She goes, the girls here really like, there's no one I would really care to do. And then this one walked by. I was like, how about that one you don't like? And she goes, oh, yeah, her, that'll do. and just got the girl's number. The girl came out and hung out and shit with us after. I mean, he couldn't do. I couldn't by myself. That girl, I was like, "Can I get your number?" She's like, "We're not allowed." They get furious and they fire us.
The next day, you.
I go really excited. I have 75 friends that have that story happening. Those guys must be lying.
The next day, you find Christine at the strip club. No underwear. No underwear. Yeah,
she got recruited.
trying to fucking pop one.
She got recruited. Let's take our second break, and we will be right back. We're hanging out with Shane Gillis, Mike Fenoya. Still the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
I think I'm really showing what I would strip to.
I was thinking that exactly.
I was like, you know what? You guys are seeing what I'd be on the pole right now.
Dude, if a girl picks one of
making
these
a
songs,
clap.
If they pick one of these types of songs, like a Big J song, mm-hmm. I'm just instantly like, ew.
Really?
Gross.
Not me. I'm like, this girl's pierced her
like
own pussy before.
Nine Inch Nails or Rob Zombie or something. Yeah. I'm just like, what's
how
the fuck?
Damaged? Yeah.
Yeah. Right. I need some Yin Yang Twins, dude.
Nah,
I
mean, like,
I want some old funk.
Yeah? Old funk?
Old funk. I want some Parliament Funkadelic or something like that.
You want people...
That's what I want.
You want your strippers to look like pictures in Scatman Crothers' room in The Shining?
Absolutely.
Just big naked bush women with like big afros petting panthers.
You know my love of black women, dude.
You do, and you like you're like Kip from Napoleon Dynamite. I just watched that last night. You want a black woman who's like bigger than you and like coming over is like,
I got it too. I love black women.
Look at that cool. Look at that vanilla ass milk dud. I wish he would try to come over here with that.
There it is.
That's Mike and LaFonda.
They still call it the White House.
I like LaFonda quite a bit.
Yeah, right. That's what I'm saying.
Damn.
See that Halloween costume? Someone went blackface and did LaFonda?
No.
Jesus, oh,
wow.
H. That's awesome.
A moron.
That's so great. Are they ethnic? That's the only way you can get out of that. If they also are some sort of ethnic. The girl looks like she might be Hispanic of some sort. And that's the guy is her owner. Like, oh, shit, it was worse than we thought. Holy shit. Stephanie Falcone.
Yeah.
She tweeted earlier, if we'd seen, Bonnie Tyler said she had a, which is an awful performance, I assume she wouldn't send it to us if it's just went swimmingly.
Yeah.
Bonnie Tyler doing, I Need a Hero. This one could hurt, because of the Bonnie Tyler songs, this is my biggie, I Need a Hero. This is the one. Everyone
I don't
else
think
goes,
I've ever heard of Bonnie Tyler
of
in my life.
Of course you have. Yes, you have. Of course. Everyone would say Total Eclipse of the Heart is their favorite and most known Bonnie Tyler song. However, that's just a bunch. I don't jump on that bandwagon because it's all a bunch of dorks who saw Old School. Mm-hmm. Not Old School. Yeah, Old School when Will Ferrell gets married in the Dan Band, which is hilarious, by the way. But people know the song from that. It bothers me.
No, you're right.
If that's the reason you know it. Bonnie Tyler was big,
that's
big star
that's
in
the Sweet Caroline of... That's a Sweet Caroline of Bonnie Tyler songs.
Yeah, some people think Sweet Caroline is a song made in Boston.
So good. Like, so good. Yeah, fuck yourself.
They think it's like a stadium song that some organ player created. People are idiots. It makes me very angry.
Me too.
But Bonnie Tyler, big star in the 80s. You know, that song was a hit. A couple big hits.
A couple of her songs would have been on the Songs Your Mom Blew Your Dad To album.
Absolutely.
For sure.
Absolutely. For sure. Yeah.
It's a compilation I'm putting together.
It's pantsuit on your knees blowjob rock.
Yeah. Perm into mustache rock.
Yes. Absolutely. Banana clip bouncing off a heavy...
Putting a scrunchie around your pubes to keep them back.
So she's saying, is it terrible? Is anyone familiar with this at all? This clip? Anybody see it at all? Jacob, I know you follow Bonnie Tyler's career very tightly. No, not today on this one. Okay.
I haven't watched it yet, but she did say, please tell me you guys saw the disaster that was Bonnie Tyler singing. I
so I assume this is Halloween?
Oh, yeah.
This must have been the Halloween episode?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is like the other day.
Yeah.
Okay.
Jesus.
Go ahead. Is that Al Roker dressed up as Mr. T? Love,
like Total Eclipse of the Heart. And
Al Roker.
Is Michael Strahan wearing blackface?
Yes. We know Bonnie Tyler is here, everybody.
Now, wait. Before she sings this song, let me explain to you why I love this song so much. This is the song that plays when Kevin Bacon in Footloose... he's fighting for the love of this.
Fuck Footloose.
Extraordinarily.
Footloose?
I love Shane. Yes.
Jay's a girl from the 80s deep down. Loves Barbara Streisand.
So wait, when you finally stopped watching West Side Story, you
it's
graduated.
I Footloose. Found Footloose. Footloose was my musical.
Before he found Bette Midler.
For the record, Footloose isn't a musical or anything gay. It's about a guy who's bringing a prom back to a town.
All right, relax.
That does not have
Footloose
a prom.
Is a gay musical, dude.
It's not a musical. There's no musical numbers in it.
Shut up.
Not a one. Not a one musical
just
number.
A
I haven't seen it, dude.
Just a lot of dancing.
If I don't dance, I'm going to die.
It's about dancing. It's not about songs. But in the movie, Kevin Bacon, rough new kid, comes to town just trying to live his life.
Rough new kid.
I relate to this. I lived at Footloose when I went to live with my father for 6 months in Ohio. No one liked the city kid coming to their little bumfuck town, and everyone's sort of mean to Kevin Bacon. Very mean to Kevin Bacon. And then he starts to fall in very serious like
maybe
one of the skinniest, most unattractive women I've ever seen in an 80s film, Laurie Singer. And this isn't gay, dude. You're gay.
What are you talking about? You said that
Shane, what are you doing in a warehouse?
Shane, you never did this in high school?
You never found an abandoned warehouse and fucking danced out your anger?
You never did coke and then did football drills in your Jordache?
You know what me and my buddies did in a warehouse, which is less gay than this? We all jerked off together.
All right.
And it's less gay than this.
It's significantly less gay.
Wow.
I think I'm with Shane.
Well, dude, the shape I was in after all my warehouse dancing, I was able to crush ass. I didn't have to jerk off in warehouses anymore.
Fuck CrossFit. This is the original CrossFit. This
look at
gay
this.
Warehouse
dance. Holy chain shit.
Swing. Oh, is it gay now? Is it a gay musical now?
Chain swing.
Okay. Is it gay now? Look what's happening right here. Look at those moves. Your heart and never. That's my favorite. The
head bob?
Yeah.
Just sprinting
if
to nowhere?
You. No.
How old were you when this came out?
31.
Dead. Yo, never.
What year was it? 84, probably? 84, you think?
When Jay has a good set on the road,
probably
he does this in the hotel.
Absolutely, man.
Oh, you were how old?
By the way, in my rider, I put uneven bars.
I need keds and uneven bars.
I need a pommel horse, uneven bars.
84.
Possibly a warehouse. 80, everything was 84, man. Yeah, so 84. So I was 7 when it came out.
All right, you're allowed to like gay stuff when you're 7.
Watched it again probably a few weeks ago with Christine. Every
really?
Time we see it's on a little bit, we got to watch some of it.
I think I liked Daryl Strawberry when I was 7.
That's straight.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Can't get
as fuck.
Straighter, yeah.
I didn't. I liked. No. You got to understand, my dad split when I was 3. Step Pop came when I was 10. So I liked. My grandfather loved music. He was a big, like, show tunes musical guy.
Wait, your grandpa? You had a gay grandpa?
No.
It's
no.
Progressive.
It is progressive, you think. He was transgender.
You had a gay pap-pap?
he called him Meemaw.
Yeah. What was his name?
Donna.
Robert.
So it was Grandma Robert?
Yeah, Grandma Robert.
Nana Bobby.
Mom Robert. So he was in the music. He definitely like got me to like all that stuff. Some of that shit. But my grandmother carried it on. My stepfather came when I was 10, and I got a little more male influence. And I had stepbrothers, too, that gave me a little more male influence. But I don't think it's not masculine to enjoy Footloose.
You want to know what my grandpa did? Grandpa Francis, he got CTE while playing at Notre Dame and fucking died, dude.
From that?
Really? Yeah, he started fighting people too much, and then he had a heart attack on the operating table.
Really?
Yeah.
He fought people on the operating table?
Probably. Yeah, actually, yes. I swear to God, that's how he died. He freaked out coming out of anesthesia and tried to fight people.
How do you know he got CTE?
I found out he got CTE because I was at my uncle's, and they showed me a newspaper clipping from 1938 or 48.
And everyone was facing forward except your dad. Grandpa.
Yeah, he was eating his leather helmet. He was held out against Purdue. He was the starting left tackle at Notre Dame. They said he couldn't play against Purdue because of a head injury.
Wow.
He cracked his fucking skull.
Holy shit.
And they were like, we'll see if we can get him to play next week.
Oh, wow. Man.
Yeah, he was retarded after that.
Yeah, they were like, just rub some dirt on it. That's how back then they helped fucking concussions. They were like, just yell at his head.
Well, not to sway too far away from our gay grandpas. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My grandfather straight.
So while your
be.
Grandpa was tap dancing.
Yes. Right. Well, my grandfather was wearing a French maid's outfit and cleaning the house, which he would say, don't tell your grandma, we all get in trouble. Do you want the family to fall apart is what he would lay on me. My grandfather was a saint.
Heavy lies the crown.
Yeah, sorry, dude.
Please don't apologize. It's hilarious.
I don't
But in Footloose, Kevin Bacon gets interested in this girl, Lori Singer, which I never quite fully understood. A little too bony for this guy's tastes. Yeah, no good. But, you know, she was a wild broad, and he was into her, and she has a much older boyfriend who's out of high school, beats her up at one point in the movie. Pretty
Fuck
graphic.
Yeah,
no
dude.
Shit. Oh, is Footloose getting less gay now? There's domestic
Wait,
abuse.
There was a dude that was dating a high school chick, and he domestically abused her?
Yeah, yeah, but
beats
he,
her
like,
up
wow.
nice.
But he,
All right.
But he dance beat her up.
No. Oh, no. But wouldn't that be great? I wish. No. Just a hardcore couple punches to the chops.
Really?
Yeah. Do Footloose beating scene.
Do they make a sequel where this guy's the hero?
No, no,
this guy fucking rocks.
No, but he might still be alive if you want to talk to a producer or something.
Dude, anybody, call in if you've domestically abused a high school girl.
When you were dating her and you were out of high school.
Dude, that could be the next Cobra Kai. Like a remake of Footloose.
So what happens with, when he's into her, that guy comes and challenges Kevin Bacon to a tractor chicken race where they will both drive tractors towards each other until one bails. Kevin Bacon's shoelace gets stuck on the wheel. He tries to bail. Shoelace gets stuck. I guess doesn't think to just take the shoe off. Instead, just freaks out the whole time, and then the other guy has to bail. Is this the beating? Yeah, here we go.
Shit. Oh, sorry.
No.
You wrap those skinny legs around anybody, won't you?
Oh!
Oh!
All right, well, she threw the
Is that
first punch.
She did hit him first. She did
I
hit him first.
I treated you decent.
I treated you decent.
It's very hillbilly.
That was it right there. He's like, I fucking loved you, you I bitch. Mean, what you made me do, dude.
Wait, it ain't over yet.
Wait.
Don't fuck with his truck,
He's got a Grateful Dead sticker in his window. Did you notice
that?
Yes. This is what Grateful Dead fans do. They date underage girls and beat them. All right, now there he just had a disarm her. And now she's still fighting. He has to subdue her. Simple. Okay, just stay down now. Stay down now. Listen. It wasn't excessive.
When he puts on a truck and
no, it's a horrible beating.
No,
and then
wasn't that? It was
she really
legal.
Wails him
before
first.
The, she does nail him first, but
and
he
then
it's
fucks his truck up.
Yeah,
I'm supporting this guy, dude. That was a good whooping she took.
It's more of like a you could subdue without fucking cracking in the face on that one, probably.
Nah.
Nah. Anyway,
she wobbled him too off that first.
But while before this beating. Maybe this is all spillover from the problem that he lost to Kevin Bacon in Tractor Chicken. But this song by Bonnie Tyler plays during Tractor Chicken. You could play the clip for a minute here.
This movie is just proof.
You know this song. Arby's uses it. I need a gyro.
This movie is just proof that the 80s was just cocaine.
It's fine. This movie's fantastic. Why don't all you just shut the fuck up? Where are you at, DJ Lou? You know you love Footloose.
I'm on your side, Jay.
I need a hero. So, a spoiler alert, Kevin Bacon wins because of the shoelace thing. But now, this is her singing that song live now on Good Morning America.
34 years later.
34 years later. And I don't think she hit it big young, Bonnie Tyler. How old is she now before we watch her? I would have said she was in her 30s, 40s when that song came out.
Yeah.
She might be 75 years old right here.
67.
She's 67?
She looks like a fucking wet bag of apples.
Because she's British.
No, dude, that's Michael Strahan. Well, she's wearing a pantsuit, which is already... Maybe she's dressed like...
There's Walter Payton.
Hillary Clinton. Let's give it a look.
You have a new album coming out. It's called Between the Earth and the Stars.
That's
and
right. Next year.
I understand
year.
That you had a dream excited. Come true.
I love that Michael Strahan has to fucking interview Bonnie Tyler. He has no clue. No clue about anything about her.
Album. What was that?
I just did a duet with Rod Stewart, and it's coming out next year around about May.
I thought that was Rod Stewart.
Yeah, her and Rod Stewart did Face Off.
Captain Stubing.
Love that costume.
We're so happy you're here.
And thank you.
When you first saw me, you just looked at me like, who is this crazy guy? But I am the guy who is going to introduce you right now. Here's Bonnie Tyler performing one of her biggest hits. Here's Holding Out for a Hero. Bonnie Tyler.
Is that what it's called? I thought it was called I Need a Hero.
Okay.
Whoa.
Come on, everybody.
Her mic's too hot. Gelman.
We're all the good men gone. We're all gone. Where's the streetwise Hercules?
Wow.
The rising
spit it out.
Isn't that what you know?
Hang on, pause it. It's like, all right, Bonnie, you cleared it. Now spit it out.
That Ninja Turtle's fucking getting into it in the back.
I gotta quit smoking.
Seriously.
Why, so you don't become Bonnie Tyler? I hope you live to fucking 67.
Look at that goddamn face.
Yeah. Ugh. I'm Steve. Late at night I touch and I tear. I dream of what I need. I need a hero. Hero till the end of the night. He's gotta be strong and he's gotta be fast. And fresh from the pike. I need a hero.
Is that her sister? Who's there in the fucking schoolgirl outfit?
That's Suzanne Summers.
That's Suzanne Summers.
That's the real Suzanne Summers.
Where?
In the one you're just looking at. In the shorts, actually.
In the back.
Right here.
Oh, Suzanne Summers?
Yeah, dude.
Look.
That's really her.
No.
Yes, it is,
Chrissy
dude.
Snow.
In the Chrissy Snow outfit.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
She looks great.
Yeah, she does. I wish they let her sing this.
Somewhere after midnight in my wildest fantasy.
She's doing what she can.
Why is she dressed like Meatloaf?
She just laughed because there's a fucking green pecker dancing in front of her.
Dude, I just wish Strahan would snap out of this fucking bullshit and freak out one of these times.
just fucking King Kong.
Like the all-time sack leader in the NFL.
He's dressed like Mr. T.
He's dressed like B.A. Baracus introducing Bonnie Tyler.
Yeah, he's got that what black people call customer service voice at all times. I just want him to freak out once. Be like, you goddamn motherfucking just spaz out.
Just die already.
It's in there. It's in there.
Yeah.
Shannon Sharpe's gonna do it first. He's gonna pop first.
Oh, for sure.
She's disgusting.
She's gonna pop first.
Oh, here comes the biggies.
She sounds like Lemmy.
Fat Slash.
Gotta be strong. He's gotta be fast. And fresh from the fight.
No one's that into it.
I think everybody back there is like, why is this taking so long?
I'll say this. Wait a second. What's the All Access 80s tour? Was there more performances by 80s people this day?
Was Benny Mardone there?
No, he swore he'd never sing that song again. I'll be honest with you. Stop it. 10 times better than anything Corey Feldman's done on Good Morning America. I mean, definitely better.
Dude.
Huh?
Feldman, he's out there trying. He's swinging, dude.
He is. So is she. I say she nailed it better.
I thought it was going to be worse.
I thought it was going to be way worse.
Can we see how she finishes it? I want to see if she makes
70 years of smoking. Her fucking lung falls out of her fucking pants.
Oh, that's it.
She starts like, Doc Holliday, like coughing up blood.
Yeah. I need Huckleberry. I need a medic. I need a fucking medic.
Shane's got to get down to his podcast over at Compound Media. Shane, thanks so much for hanging out.
Oh,
with us,
thank
man.
You, dude.
Make sure you guys check out Shane on social media. You guys all know Shane and love Shane. Anywhere you're performing, you want to plug?
Some fucking place in Syracuse on the 15th.
That'll get him there.
Yeah, that'll get him there.
That'll get him there, buddy. Shane, we love having you on the show, man. Thanks for hanging out, dude. I appreciate it. Can you think of it? You have the thing? If you have it, please
Woody's.
It.
It's called Woody's in Syracuse.
Woody's
November 15th.
Syracuse.
Also, Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast. Shout out Matt McCusker. Suck our dicks.
We love you, Shane Gillis. We're hanging out with Mike Fenoy and the rest of the show.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
If anybody can call in 1-844-COMEDY-9, let us know if you know what this song is from. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Big Jay Oakerson. Dan Soder off getting what I can only describe as on-screen attacked right now on the set of Billions. Sitting in with us today, of course, America's amigo Mike Fenoya, who's going to have his next amigo show live at the Comedy Cellar November 21st. That is not the podcast live. That is the show.
It's a live show.
You and three friends.
Yep.
Amigos.
Amigos, if you will. You've done it.
Yes, I have. You get your tickets. Great show. Get your tickets at thecomedycellar.com, comedycellar.com, and be sure and download his Amigos podcast as part of iTunes. Doing good numbers, you told me.
It's doing great. It's doing a lot of fun, yeah.
So good. Dan Soder going to be at Rumors in Winnipeg, Canada, November 15th through the 17th. After that, he's going to be at Laugh Boston November 29th through December 1st. Get tickets at dansoder.com. Check out our videos on Comedy Central's YouTube. Half-hour clips of the show. So fun to be in the room with us. We're trying to do some big things with that. Best of the Bonfire, the podcast. You know, download it wherever you get podcasts from. Please rate, review. Let us know you're listening. Me, I'm going to be in Hasbrook Heights, New Jersey this weekend.
Me too.
With Mikey Fenoya. We're going to be at Bananas Friday, Saturday. One show Friday, two shows Saturday. Come check us out. Come hang. It'll be a blast. And then, of course, Homecoming, Philadelphia. Mike goes down with me there also. Christine's going to be along for the ride. It's going to be a fun weekend, man.
Yeah.
I want to sell out all those shows. Thursday, too. Hmm. I want it to be a full weekend party. It's going to be a...
I can't wait,
dude. I'm so excited. Mike's never played Philly before.
No, and I'm stoked to go after the special came out, and it's like right around the holidays. It's really fucking, I'm excited for it, man.
I'm not going to beat myself up that weekend for the eating I do.
No.
I'm not going to go haywire.
This is our Thanksgiving.
I'm not going to go haywire all weekend, but we're going to eat a little bit. Yeah, I'm sick of going there and just like
Well, we
got
to take Mikey to Lorenzo's and get slices on the street.
Yeah.
And do all
stoked.
The fun stuff.
I love Philly. I've been there a whole bunch of times, like seeing Fish and going to concerts at the Spectrum and all that, but we've never really
pork from Tony. He'll love a roast pork from Tony Luke's. It'll blow his mind.
Yeah, I'm stoked for it, dude.
Blow his mind.
Go out and fucking see the shows, man. It's gonna be a blast. And then we're in San Fran not too long after.
That is correct, buddy. We are rolling around this country. No one in our audience knows what that song is from. Flashdance, everybody. The hottest scene to me. I know there's a lot of scenes. Everyone's gonna throw to Jennifer Beals, but Jennifer Beals was hot for sure in the movie, but that girl, and the only other thing I know her from was she was the girl in the Frank Stallone's band who liked John Travolta in Staying Alive.
Jesus
remember, she
Christ,
was in a band?
Dude. Yep.
Anybody remember Staying Alive here?
Mm-hmm.
Am I the only asshole? Oh, thank you, Lou.
Yeah.
You think Frank Stallone didn't have a hit? I'll fist fight you right now. Someone in the room say it. This doesn't make you want to put on leg warmers and a fucking one piece and just get out there.
See, the can was good. Yeah, this makes you want to do coke and clean your apartment.
Fuck yeah, man. These songs make Christine jittery.
Yeah, this
not
is
me.
Serious.
I love them.
This is snowstorm music. This stepping out. I love this shit.
I never equated to that. You'd be punch dancing in a warehouse.
Yeah.
On coke.
On coke.
I don't duke. I've never done coke.
That's like that fortune cookie thing where you say, like, in bed after every fortune and it works.
You guys are all coked up. I'm just fucking fat kid with Oreo crumbs on my face. Punch fighting in a fucking...
It's your cardio.
On your Nintendo.
This
your
is Nintendo the trackpad. Who's this girl? Who played this girl? I want to see. I bet she held up good. I thought she was hot and everything. Short 80s career, I think.
Dude, it's that weird 80s hot, too. That's like it's like a real part of time where there
well, they
was
came
that
in triple
80s.
Threat, first of all. I think she's clearly a dancer. That's her doing it.
Yeah.
So she was a dancer. I think she sings a little bit, too. Triple threat, I guess not great at any of those things to make either of them really pop for
She's 33% good at three things.
She's triple threat. She's got triple warning.
I think this might be
It
her.
Is. It is
Wait,
her.
Cynthia Rose, is she Dirty Dancing? The
She was not Dirty Dancing.
Why can't remember her name? Not...
Yeah, she's the one. She's the slut who got pregnant by the guy. Because she's a pig and Robbie got her in trouble.
I didn't know. She's married to Richard Marx.
I'm just kidding. That's what they thought, right? They called her a slut. Everyone thought she was a slut for fucking
Yeah, they thought Johnny did it. I just watched Dirty Dancing this weekend along with Daria.
By the way, on coke?
That's not the first time you've watched that recently.
It's just on TV, and when it's on, how could you flip off?
It's like Goonies.
Very easily.
Well, that's my Roadhouse.
You don't turn off Roadhouse. I swear to you, Christine, I thought about if there was no one in here, I would have thrown my phone at you for saying that.
In my world, you don't turn off Dirty Dancing or Clueless or Practical Magic.
You both have your Swayze movie that you won't turn off.
Yeah.
Practical magic? You don't turn off?
I mean, that one's just for me. I get it.
What don't I turn off? I don't turn off Toto's Africa when it comes across
the
playlist.
Fuck no. You kidding me? There have been times where you've almost, you've skipped past it and then gone back and been like, what was I thinking?
Yeah, I have.
You really have. Multiples.
I don't do that.
There's a, I mean, song-wise, I mean, it's, yeah.
There's a lot of ones you just don't go past.
Right.
This is not one of them.
Yeah,
you can go right past this.
Skip this in a heartbeat.
Yeah, Cynthia wrote, but that was it. I'm telling you, her career was 80s, right? Go to IMDb.
Well, say, it seems like her main thing was dancing. I want to see maybe she had.
And banging Richard Marx, apparently. I didn't know she was married to Richard Marx.
It looks like she stopped acting in 1991.
She was in Tom Selleck's future action-adventure Runaway.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Starring, she's in the Toto video Rosanna.
Starring Gene Simmons.
She's the woman in red in Rosanna.
That's pretty great.
When that's the best 80s video ever, with everything's in a wet alley surrounded by a fence.
She's also in a Tubes video, but is that for One in a Million?
No.
You sure?
I
know, but it just says Tubes. It seems like they don't know.
I don't know. Do the
they
Tubes
couldn't
have...
get actually Rosanna Arquette for this?
Everything's in a fenced-in alley that's kind of wet.
That's her. Yeah, she was nice. Songs about Rosanna Arquette. I guess they couldn't get her. They got this dancer actress.
Yeah.
She was shooting Desperately Seeking Susan.
Go to the Tubes,
pass.
One in a Million. They can't have a video for another song.
They actually do have a couple of...
That's bizarre. Man, Toto. You were never awesome. Yeah, she was so cute.
Do you know the Tubes keyboard player Vince Welnick ended up being the last keyboard player for the Grateful Dead?
No, I didn't. My friend's dad.
Quit pulling your sister's hair.
Are you trying to molest me when your son falls asleep? That guy always, I just wish that guy was my dad.
I think that
up.
Guy is my dad.
The mustache, yeah, sort of is.
He looks just like my father.
Did you find the One in a Million video for scene?
No, it's
the Tubes.
Not.
I don't like that.
The Tubes. She's a beauty, or the romantic.
She's a beauty. She's a beauty.
She's a beauty.
She's a beauty. Sorry.
I don't like his just gaze into nowhere.
I do. And it says she's dancer in this. Is that possible? Because you will not believe such a good tune. She's right here behind the glass. I thought she's a robot or
this
something.
This has to be a stripper song, right? Never heard anybody. I mean,
well, no, the song's about a stripper.
I know, that's
No, but how do you dance to this now?
That's like running to Chariots of Fire.
You got a white girl with cornrows dancing to this? Good luck, buddy.
Let's hear it for Diamonds. One in a million.
Yo, I don't care.
This has got people.
Jump ahead in this video. I'm waiting to see a dancer.
Wait, that's her coming in.
Yeah, I think it is. That's a...
No, that's a boy.
Oh, that Peter might Chris. Be her. That could be her.
One of these girls.
Wow, yeah, there's a million ads, probably.
Hang on. You can say anything you like. I like to believe it's that one there.
You know what I came across online?
Cynthia Rhodes. Is that her name, Cynthia Rhodes?
Mm-hmm.
Nailed it. Is her? You think it is her?
Yeah.
Look at that, Jacob. This video? You wanted to be that kid so bad? You, a young Jacob, wearing a sleeveless dungaree vest your white sleeves of your t-shirt poking out.
Your candy cigarettes rolled in your right sleeve.
Oh, hell yeah. Lucky Spikes.
Lucky Spikes.
Oh, I didn't notice there was areolas on his fucking drum kits.
Oh, he busted.
Anybody else
right
catch
through.
That? I used to watch it on MTV. Maybe. And then a child? They show tits than a child.
Popping through the nipple.
I'm the creep. Okay, America.
Did you ever watch Legs? Legs Incorporated? Legs Inc. It was like this show in England, and there were just these dancing chicks that would come out and dance to a song, like you know what I mean? It was
called
Legs.
But it's like
there was never a live performance. It was just part of a TV show in England.
Oh, I thought it was saying Benny Hill.
It's like Legs Incorporated.
That was the earliest version of late night TV where you were like, oh, maybe we'll see a little not boob, but girl in a bikini on TV.
Plus,
jumping.
Little side bush.
Jumping around. No side bush, man. This was way censored TV. That shows my age so much. Every show now on basic cable that's like a popular show is now whipping out like these motherfuckers have this. And every time I still get like a wow.
Is this it, Christine? Did you find it?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is that weird fucking.
No.
Oh no.
You're like, all right, FX. I guess you're going for it, huh? I still have like a little like I get skittish about it. I'm like, ooh.
Remember when NYPD Blue was like the first one that like
they
really
showed
kinda...
a man's ass. They lured the world into that one. They go, new first time nudity tonight on TV. First time. And it was a man's ass. Wasn't it not a great one either? Wasn't it Michael Chiklis' ass or something?
The commish?
Wasn't it the commish's ass?
His ass had a receding hairline, too.
It, or David Caruso or something.
But there was tons of swearing.
Ginger freckle
shit.
Ass.
Right? Wasn't there lots of...
Buddy, I don't know how long it is till NBC, CBS start coming off it and doing it. Because SVU, Law & Order SVU, is desperately trying to keep up. And they are showing much more violent attacks and murders, but they're not going on the language at all.
Not
they're
at all.
They're not really bending on the language very much, NBC. But I'm telling you, they're going to have to do it to keep up because now, on FX now, I mean, seems like almost no restriction. So it was like, why not? She's probably up there sucking his dick. Like, they'll say things like that. And you're like, holy shit.
But those shows like Law & Order and all those have always been like, it's dirty without being dirty.
Oh,
it's like, they found like 12 gallons of cum in her,
we did
in
a rape
vaginal
kit,
cavity. Yeah.
And we didn't have enough Dixie cups to get all the cum that came out.
My tight little. Some after 10 p.m. rule.
Yeah, that was the NYPD Blue thing.
Yeah, but I don't think it's... I'm
it
sure.
It might not be that.
I thing. Think now it's just across the board. But those shows aren't all on after 10 p.m. Now,
But it's...
Well, here's what's funny is, to be realistic, these are always situations you'd watch a show on for years where you're like, how is no one cursing here?
Yeah.
You know?
Mm.
To have somebody go like, you're being a real jerk back there.
Yeah.
On like, you know, a horror show.
Right.
Or something like American Horror Story. And you're like, would be a lot of cursing in
the
show.
Yeah, it's like,
show.
You quit yanking my crank.
So I feel like someone just finally got that message. Like someone young enough and just like finger on the pulse enough got the word of that and changed the rules. However, it just hits me weird. Like now if I was watching a show on HBO, I wouldn't think twice about it. Right. Just like that I'm aware I'm watching a TV show where when you hit play on like a cable show, a part of you just has a belief like, how bad could this really be?
Right,
you know what I mean?
Right.
When they show you something, you're like, holy shit. And I've watched, I went through the list of 25 most disturbing movies in history ever made
on
the road. I've watched them all.
You've watched all of them?
Yeah, the ones I could get through. And I don't mean get through like I can't handle it. Just like some of them are such shitty movies. And it's just like you're waiting in the middle to see when a guy cuts a girl in half by the pussy or something. And I'm like, I don't care enough about it.
Yeah.
But like, most of them. I mean, a Serbian film is the most horrific thing I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, that one you told me about a bunch. Yeah, what the hell was that?
I'd watch it again. It's mind-blowing, like the storyline of this thing. You know what that is?
Mm-mm.
A Serbian film? I don't want to give spoilers.
Yeah, that's bananas.
I told you about
that. Yeah, you told me about it. I haven't watched it. It's not that I won't watch it. I just haven't.
It's all kinds of a fucked up story.
And all the years we lived together, the only times we ever talked about it was on the road.
Yeah.
And I didn't want to watch it in the hotel stoned and then be like, oh, I'm going to walk back down the hall and like be, you know.
Well, it's not that kind of film. You can. It's disturbing. It's not a...
Those are the ones that tend to be the more fucked up for me, though. Like, Clockwork Orange is a horror movie to me.
Yeah, that
not,
film...
Not Saw.
I think we talked about it on the show before, but a film called The Girl Next Door, not the light romp with Emil Hirsch and Elisha Cuthbert. It was movie... It's Jack something's... It's a name that, like, you're like, oh, he's got fucked up stuff. I can't remember.
Ketchum?
Jack Ketchum. The Girl Next Door movie they made about two young girls whose parents were in an accident, so they go to live with their weird aunt, who's like an eccentric, weird, sexed up lady.
Really?
Yeah, I don't want to say weird like anymore. And she's jealous of the older daughter and just like entices all the boys to come over and like she just makes them all like maniacs, like beating this girl and raping, like very graphic.
Is it new?
No. It was 2007. Yeah. And by the way, the person who's narrating it, talking about a story as a little boy, fucking Dickless from the EPA in Ghostbusters.
No.
Go really? Back to the beginning of this trailer. It shows him. See? It's fucking Dickless.
Wow.
It is true.
In my life.
Walter Peck.
Summer of 1958.
Carrie Hathaway.
this man has no dick.
Time when even the guilty displayed a rare innocence.
I mean, by the time this movie gets to it, they're putting out cigarettes on this girl, and she's naked. He wants to sleep over there. Graphically, naked, tied to like a bed frame, and she just lets her own cousins like have at it first, and they fight. It's just so crazy.
Oh, dude,
it's awful. Badass. Oh, Jacob came.
Oh.
Yeah, it's all kinds of fucked up. I've watched it four times. Anything that I'm appalled by, I have to go back and be like, is this happening?
Watch it a couple more times. Do you remember that one that we watched that was the chat room? Was that what it was called? Chat room? Do you remember that, Christine?
Or oh, the like, horror movie.
The horror movie where like everyone in the chat.
Yeah, but those are the movies. What I was going to say was
those are so, to me, but that's called a horror movie. There's nothing fucking scary about that at all. This, to me, is terrifying.
Yes, I am much more terrified by it. It's just
the
darkness.
Psychological, like locking someone in a basement kind of thing, is that to me is a horror movie. Clockwork Orange, I still can't, like, Full Metal Jacket to me was kind of like that.
I know, by the way, yeah, turn the volume up on this so you can hear this ant. Huh?
Not so fun when it's your precious sister getting slapped around. Teach you to pick on people your own size.
You brought a cop here. After my mother!
Oh, it's so weird. They just have kids, other kids beat them up. It's just
and it looks like it's terrible acting, too.
About what? Getting big into the game?
Photographer Becky, can you stop staring at the screen like this was your childhood? I met your parents. This didn't happen to you. Jesus Christ, you got intense.
You didn't blink.
She was looking, she goes, that son of a bitch will never do that to me. He goes, I met your father. It doesn't strike me as that guy. Seemed like everyone was pretty happy family. She really had it. Never again.
That's fucking hilarious.
It's a fucked up movie. But yeah, I've watched it several times.
Is it a good, but is like the source of like the 25 scariest movies like a good source, or is it one of those dumb like fucking, you know,
go bring the list up, most disturbing films, most not disturbing. Scariest
whatever most disturbing,
big deal, big
but
difference.
are the classics on it are like Friday the 13th and like
No,
more.
Is this it?
No, is this on IMDb?
No, there's no there's just a list, like if you look it up, 25 most disturbing films,
and it's like international,
it's the same
shit.
But that's not even, it's just the, of course, but yeah. It's just the same, like that list is just echoed everywhere.
I've got 50.
Well, like Pet Cemetery?
No, dude, I'm telling you. More fucked up shit. Mother? All right, they added this list. Mother stinked.
Stunk. It stunk so bad it stinked.
Bone Tomahawk. Haven't watched it fully yet. It was a little boring, the part I saw. Raw, didn't see that. That's a lesbian cannibal movie. We Are the Flesh, I've never seen. They're doing some no longer with Dogtooth, nothing. The Skin I Live In, not a once. Pig, don't even know what that is.
These are all brand new.
Gerald's Game, not that disturbing, quite honestly. Baskin, no idea.
Look at that. That's
maybe. The Killing of a Sacred Deer, don't even know what that is. Hostel, yes, yeah, saw that. Disturbing for sure. For sure disturbing. It's Hostel 1 caught you.
Number 50.
Yeah, there's more. Natural Born Killers, not disturbing, just no. Awesome.
Such a fucking just light.
Trans-Siberia, never saw it. I told you I saw 25 of them. Valhalla Rising, don't know what that is. Clockwork Orange, yes, saw it.
Scariest movie ever.
It was fine. Human Centipede 2, full sequence, saw it. Pretty disturbing. Exorcist, that's dated.
It's disturbing.
We need to talk about Kevin. Yeah, that's pretty fucked up.
You saw this? I haven't seen
it. It's not, but it's like still, whenever you see John C. Reilly, you can't really... Yeah. Dive fully into like the disturbing nature.
Dewey Cox is in a fucking
movie. 7, come on.
Disturbing.
I know. I Spit on Your Grave, 78. Sure. At the time, it was a very graphic rape scene. Man Bites Dog. No. Don't know what that is. Gummo. Sure. That was weird.
What's Gummo about?
It's the same guy that made Kids. He just went and filmed it in West Virginia with some actors. Chloe Sevigny's in it. And actual local, just like.
Yeah. Like
drank 12, power line water or something,
yeah, like
their whole life.
Cousins, 12 cousins deep into a fucking incest.
Yeah.
Hey.
So you see some real like human horrors.
Power line water. That's fucking great. That's like a new Gatorade.
power line
water.
Murder Set Pieces is stupid. That stinks. I saw it. Bunny Game. Don't know. There's gonna be Funny Games. Yes, super fucked up. That's a really fucked up movie. Funny. If you haven't seen that one, Funny Games.
I haven't seen it.
And they made an American one that's not quite... It's still pretty good, but it's not nowhere near as fucked up as...
What's that? Canadian? Is that what that said?
No, it's French, I think. Oh. Night and Fog. No idea. Snowtown Murders. Started it, boring as shit. Sweet movie. No idea.
Dude.
Dead Girl. Now we're getting the ones I know. This is pretty fucking fucked. This is fucked up. Dead Girl is about a, these guys find a cadaver, but it's like sort of, it's like a come to life witch or something like that, if I remember. Anyway, it's like a, actually it's a zombie.
Uh-huh.
It's like a hot zombie, and one, like two kids find her, and the one kid's telling the nicer kid to shut up about it because he starts charging people to come fuck her.
Wow.
That's what it's about, yeah. Yeah, it's pretty weird.
That's real weird. Oh, but, yeah, I got to.
Antichrist.
I don't want to ruin
boring it. As nuts. So boring. Happiness. Fucked up movie. Did you ever see that?
No.
That's a really. Oh, it's yeah. Todd Solondz. That's got some weird scenes in it. It's a heartwarming conversation, yeah, between a father and son about penis size.
Wow.
And forget even that. He starts. The father's a pedophile who fucks his son's friends and then talks to his son about it like in a real fatherly, like, it's so crazy.
Holy shit.
Crazy fucked up movie. Keep going. We could tear through these. Kill List. Don't know. I don't know what the hell that is. Oh. 1929, I thought there was no film.
Un Chien Andalou?
Old Boy. Fucked up movie. The Korean one. Super fucked up.
Old Boy.
Awesome, though. High Tension's fine. Eyes Without a Face, I don't know. I Stand Alone, no idea. Begotten, never heard of it.
This list.
Man Behind the Sun, what are you talking about?
No such place.
Ichi the Killer, couldn't stay with it. Martyrs, pretty fucked up. Pretty fucked up movie. Yeah, that's good.
Eraserhead.
I can't. It bores me always. I love David Lynch.
Yeah, you're a David Lynch
Blood
guy.
Blood Feast,
too.
I don't know. Inside, no idea. Visitor Q, never even heard
the
of it.
The reason we can blow through this list is because we can blow through any list.
15's a Serbian film? Get the fuck out of here.
Top 20 places to visit.
15's a Serbian film? Then I'm going to spoiler alert that right now. They trick a guy into fucking his own son.
Dude.
While his brother in law fucks his wife. All in, it's insane.
God damn.
That's,
every movie has rape in it.
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, they're disturbing.
Right.
August Underground. That might be the three most disturbing films ever. August Underground, there's three of them. It's a home movie. It's thrill kill.
Oh, yeah.
I told you about it. It's all kinds of fucked up. A lot of weird nudity. And this is strange. Why it's so scary, like the nudity of it, what adds to the scary is they didn't just get, it's not like horror movies where it's a bunch of big fake titted things. It's like chubby women, not like super like attractive actor, not to be mean at all,
sure, but
they're made to be like, oh, just very like regular girls in a house or girls from a store, and it's real torture. Yeah, but the guy, what it is the guy, I've looked into the guy, because I'm Fred Vogel, I think his name is.
Mm-hmm.
Fred Vogel is just a student of Tom Savini. Nah, his name's not Savini, that's Chloe Savini. Tom. He's a movie makeup guy. He played Sex Machine in Dust Till Dawn. I can't remember his name.
Okay.
But he went to his school of special effects makeup, so it's just a whole thing to make it look like, how much with a home video camera and my special effects can I make it look like I'm pulling guts out of somebody? Tom Savini.
That's what it is.
And he really does. Last House on the Left is not more disturbing than August Underground. Titicut Follies, I've never heard of.
That sounds fucking hilarious.
I don't know what that is either.
Flowers of Flesh and Blood.
Irreversible, really fucked up movie, for sure. Requiem for a Dream. I'll tell you what, I'm surprised this list, because they're going a little more Hollywood towards the end. Because I'm telling you, Serbian film is the most fucked up film I've ever seen.
Uh-huh.
Most fucked up. I know what they're going to get to, too. I can predict the next one. It's going to be Sallow, 100 Days of Sodom. Will be coming up, and the number one is going to always be Caligula, they're going to say. Audition's pretty fucked up, not the craziest thing in the world. Pink Flamingos is just because of fat tranny shits. Cannibal Holocaust is pretty fucked up. You got to find that online. That's a weird one. Necromaniac, I never saw. And number one, Sallow, 100 Days of Sodom. 120 Days of Sodom. Boring as shit. Most disturbing film ever? Boring as shit.
Yeah.
It's just stupid and dumb. It's like ridiculous. It's not very good at all. But I can't believe Caligula wasn't on there at all.
Yeah.
It's so weird. Well, anyway, there's your list, everyone.
I like doing lists like this.
Not sure if I caught 25 of those, but I guess I found a different list.
Top 10 places to visit. Fiji, never been there. Next.
Five of them? Oh, I've seen a bunch. I'm telling you, though, I saw the most fucked up ones on there, I think, and they are definitely out of order. To have August Underground 1 be up there and none of the other two.
Throw little children on the list. Jackie Earl Haley.
Oh, yeah, it's pretty fucked up. But August Underground, you can only find it's a shitty copy of a shitty copy online. But man, crazy.
Scary shit.
Just nuts.
So it's like when you turn it off, you're like, fucking wow.
Absolutely, man. Shane Gillis hung out with us earlier. You can check out his podcast as part of Compound Media, called A Fair One. And, you know, follow him online, social media. We love Shane. Mike, thanks so much for hanging out with us today.
Thanks for having me.
Mike, of course, the Amigos, live at the Comedy Cellar, November 21st. Get your tickets at ComedyCellar.com. And make sure you download the Amigos podcast on iTunes. Dan, Soder.com for all of his dates. He's got Winnipeg coming up. He's got, I should know this, he's got Laugh Boston coming up. I'm at Bananas this weekend, Hasbrook Heights, and then Philly after that. Get your tickets, please. Early and buy a lot.
Yeah.
BigJComedy.com. My special is part of the Netflix Degenerates. Please check it out. It's running right now. First episode on the thing. Check it out. I'm getting the feedback's been overwhelmingly great.
Dude, it's fantastic.
It's really awesome, man. Check out our podcast. Check out our live videos on Comedy Central's YouTube page. On behalf of Jacob, the Lou's, Christine, and the boys, we will catch you guys live next week. Enjoy new Lost Tapes tomorrow.
See you in Jersey.
Crackle, crackle.